Prior to SDK 1210, the phased array antenna created a beam towards every object of interest that was in view, going into here and specifying your objects of interest from all available objects. The problem here is that it would put a beam on every single one of those that are in view. So if there were 10 of them in view, you would end up with 10 beams. And this can be a problem in two ways. One, it's not necessarily the visual aspect that they want. And two, we'll see later, as each one of these beams come in, your performance, your system performance will degrade. All right, so let me go. What we introduced in SDK 1210 is a couple extra parameters here. We introduced a maximum selection count. It defaults to 1,000, just to, should be plenty for backwards compatibility. And then, of course, if you're going to pick, let's say, I want only two beams, you're going to need a way. The user needs some sort of selection method, target selection method, to say which of those 10, 20, 30 targets do I want to pick the two beams that I can form towards. And we provided a couple simple methods to do that. Right now, it's simply range, closing velocity, or priority based. And I'll get into these a little bit later. And coming down the pike then will be some common ones, like, let's say, receive power, maximum receive power. Let me put this back to 1,000. What we saw here is, as these came in, we're going to have a bunch of beams. And that's not necessarily what the user wanted. So we can put in two here. And now we can see, as we animate, we're going to end up with, as we bring in each one of these, we're going to form a beam. Another one comes in, we'll form another beam. But at some point in time, we're going to stop, and we're only going to be forming two beams. So let me jump over to this particular was using range. I'm going to jump over to another scenario to kind of show you what the other options are. In the next case, it would be closing velocity. Okay, in this scenario, we have multiple aircraft, two aircraft flying in, and we have a slow-moving ship here. We are setting up our antenna to, say, two beams. We're interested in all these four objects in our scenario, but of these four, we may only be able to at most put in a maximum of two beams. And we're gonna pick based on our target selection strategy based on closing velocity. So in our scenario, we have a slow moving ship here, and then we have two higher speed aircrafts come flying in. This one will only come into view around here, and we'll hit animate here, and we'll see what happens. And then this one is going to end up launching a kinetic weapon at some point, somewhere around in here. And we'll jump over to here. We can see that we got our two beams. We're targeting our slow-moving adversary and this aircraft that came into view. And now we just, the other high-speed aircraft came in. We are now pointing in at both of them. And our ship is being a slow-moving vessel, we're decided to pick up the faster targets. And eventually, right about here, we're going to end up not having enough beams to account for additional targets that come into the theater. So we end up picking a high-speed deployment from aircraft 6. And that should come in right about here. And once he picks that up, he's going to stop tracking that aircraft. And once that kinetic object is taken out, it's going to flip over to what's in view yet here with the highest closing velocity, which would be in the ship and this aircraft, until all of them are no longer threats. All right, that was closing velocity. And finally, I'll touch upon priority based as a final demo. Okay, this scenario isn't really a use case per se, but it's but it's a test, a scenario to show you a concept. And that's, so basically I have four aircraft and a receiver on here, and my facility is here with my antenna. These four aircraft are going to come in every, I think, 20 seconds. But what we're doing here is we're setting up our phased array antenna to have priority. And with priority, the user can specify a priority value anywhere from 1 to 1,000, 1 being the most, the highest priority. Right now, we're going to keep them all the same at their default values. And when we come over here and play this, we're going to see every 20 seconds or I'm animating every 10 seconds. So every 10 seconds, a new aircraft comes in, and you can see each time an aircraft came in, we end up with another beam. The report here I'm running is a link budget report, and I just wanted to show you here that you can see as each beam comes in, every 20 seconds, every 20 seconds, it's going to degrade our EIRP. So that's what I had mentioned earlier about, you know, there's two things that's going on here. You got a visual effects, which you may not necessarily want all of the beams showing of all your objects of interest. So that was the one aspect. And the other aspect is the fact that it will degrade your EIRP, and the amount of energy you're going to transmit will slowly degrade as you go through more and more, bring on more and more beams. So let's go back into here real quick, and we're going to just set these up. Let's say aircraft four has our receiver on it. So let's say he's our main priority. We want to be able to communicate to him, and then we're just going to just run through these 10. We just increment these 10, 20, and 30. And these are going to come in at basically opposite times. So when we animate this again, we're going to bring it in, and we're going to see now, whoops. And did not do what I thought it was going to do. Well, we need to set this to 2, of course, right? So, and when we animate now, we should only see 2 beams. We're going to come in here, and you can see it is slowed down a little bit. We only ever had 2 beams coming in, and that is priority based, because as we bring in each one, so we went aircraft 3, 4, 3, 2, and 1. So that must be the order of our priorities. And we do, yep, 3, 2, 1, 1 being highest priority. We could turn this around and do 30, 10, 30, 20, and 10. And now we should see the, we'll see it come in as a different order. There you go. It never changes. So anyway, that is the feature. This came in. So this was just part of subarrays, along with a bunch of other things that are going to be coming in soon. This is just setting up a pathway to bring in more capabilities of the subarray features, the feature that got put on hold, but there are certainly a lot of pieces of subarrays that can be brought in, and this is just one step towards bringing in some things. The next step would be, you know, bringing in the ability to make a decision based on received power, as a follow-on things are going to be coming from that as well.